Hello, I'm Jason Glenn. I'm an associate professor in the Department of History and Philosophy of Medicine at the University of Kansas Medical Center. I think the promise is the fantasy that we have about genetic research. Understanding the genes are going to solve all of our problems. Our greatest peril is to also think of people as potentially genetic defective. Devising medical technologies to quote-unquote correct or eliminate people that we think are genetic defectives. So there are approximately 10% of illnesses have genetic linkages. We estimate that there will be only 1 to 5% of people who have those illnesses who will be able to afford genetic therapies. Right now, genetic therapies range between $500,000 and $1.4 million. Private insurance companies don't want to pay for that. Because we get so excited about genetic research, we tend to disregard the vast majority of illnesses that we know that are caused by environmental degradation, inequality, and poverty. One of the promises that people get excited about is the idea for gene editing, you know, potential embryos, taking out specific genes that we think might be linked to things like intelligence, athletic ability, music ability, eye color, hair color, those sorts of things, right? So there's a problem in terms of there's no mass market to bring the pricing down. Because there's no mass market to bring the pricing down, this is going to continue to be a technology available to the 1%.
Support for local programming around the new Ken Burns series, The Gene, is made possible by a grant from presenting station WETA, with additional support from the Kansas City University and the Center for Practical Bioethics.